The way this game works is pretty simple. You come up with an Australian slang word or phrase you think I do not know, and I will try to guess what the fuck it means.
Dari.
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 A dari.
A dari. Spell it for me.
D-U-R-R-Y.
Didn't know. Okay. Dari. Give it to me in a sentence.
Fangus a dari.
Only in Australia would context make something more difficult to understand.
I'm amazed you still ask the question, to be honest. Yes.
Fang us, okay.
I like that literally every word in that sentence is a trick, because even the us is inaccurate, you know? That's very nice. That is very nice.
Is it give or can I have?
Yeah. Can I have is a fucking polite way to put it. That is essentially the essence of the sentence, absolutely.
Cigarette? Yes! That's the only one I'm gonna get.
That's true.
I'll be honest, I was very surprised.
Yeah, when someone says, fuck me dead, mate.
When someone says, fuck me dead, mate.
Yeah, and it is.
That sounds like a bad weekend.
Yeah, it's not like a cemetery thing, you know? Like, I want to make that clear.
Okay, fuck me dead, mate. Okay, well, I do know that mate can either mean friend or person I'm about to glass.
Yeah, that is absolutely right, mate.
A bit of a holy shit, but maybe like a modern Shiver Me Timbers. Do you know what I mean? Like you see something and you're like, oh, what the hell? Like that. Is it?
Sorry, a modern Shiver Me Timbers.
Pretty much.
Holy fuck!
That, like that, I'm not wrong on that, am I? That's pretty much. Yeah, just like, oh
yeah,
my god.
Yeah, because I thought it was like an exclamation, right?
Yeah, kind of like an oh my god, you know?
Goon of fortune.
Oh! Yeah. Goon of fortune. I'll give you some context.
Fucking good.
I don't know if you remember the last times I gave you context.
Oh, good point.
Yes. It is a game.
Well, it's when you have to find a goon.
That's not incorrect.
Is it hide and seek?
Dude, Steve, this is an adult game. This is not... I mean, I guess you can be underage if you're a fucking hero. But, you know, it is predominantly, you know, an adult game.
An adult game.
An adult game.
So, is it Australia's immigration policy?
Nah, more people win Goon of Fortune.
It's some sort of a drinking game, or...?
Yes, yeah, absolutely right, yeah.
Okay, how does it work?
Well, that's for you to explain, man. Don't tell me.
Okay, everybody, you put your goon on the table.
No, not the table. But you put your goon on something. So goon, it's a type of alcohol.
It's a type of alcohol.
How about this? A type of alcohol receptacle.
So is it like a bagged wine? So the goon is a bag of wine.
Yes.
Is it, do you bounce it on someone's head?
No, but we should start doing that. So with the Hills Hoist, you put the goon on the Hills Hoist using 2 to 3 pegs. 3 is preferable, 2 is fun. You spin it, everyone stands around it, whoever it lands in front of drinks goon from the bag.
You know, now I understand your political system. Do you want to do reverse icebreakers now?
Yeah, so next game, reverse icebreakers. You know icebreakers. You guys have done icebreakers, right? Icebreaker questions. It's like you just met someone, you don't want to offend them because it's a corporate retreat, so you ask them something shit like, if you could have any superpower, would it be heaps of money or no insurance? You know, like some shit like that. I've never had a job. Is that how it works? I don't know. Anyway, so basically we've made that a bit more fun. So instead of that, you give us the answer and then Steve and I will try and guess the question.
And the key is, we are not trying to be accurate.
Ford Fiesta.
Ford Fiesta. A Ford Fiesta, what does a Kia Rio laugh at?
That took me a second, but I liked it.
Thank you.
You know what else takes a second? A Ford Fiesta. Not a good car.
What did you hit a kangaroo with and the kangaroo laughed at you?
I don't mind that, actually. So you reckon, did you hit something with the Ford Fiesta? Give us some con... It was a thumbs up!
The kangaroo.
What? You hit a kangaroo...
Wait,
a kangaroo
serious?
Hit...
Yes.
Okay, I'm
yes.
sorry, a little disbelief.
Yes!
We've never got one right before. It's been 2 years, Steve.
Hold on a second. I didn't realize that kangaroos were really that prevalent here. Yeah. That is like the stereotype that they tell Americans. We're like, ha, ha, ha. And I'm like, wouldn't it be funny if it was a kangaroo? She's like, no, yes, that is what happened. I hit a kangaroo on my way to work at the kangaroo place. And
that's the name of the street, Kangaroo Place. They all fucking live there. It's unbelievable. Sorry,
that's located in the kangaroo district.
Can we just so Steve doesn't go back to America being like, they are everywhere. Like, it was on like a country road,
right? It was on the way to Stanthorpe. Late
American, night. Stanthorpe. He doesn't know where Canada is, exactly. Like, come on, Stanthorpe? Really?
How dare you? It's our hat. We wear it when it gets cold.
So you drive out west and it gets a little bit bushy and it's late in the afternoon and then kangaroos
that
jump out in front of you!
Condescending. But also deserved.
That is not where I was going with that. When she started doing that, I was like, this is the exact sex education I got at Catholic school. You know, you start going west, it gets a bit bushy.
And suddenly there was a tail.
And a pouch.
The answer is Volodymyr Zelensky.
The answer is Volodymyr Zelensky. What is something not to bring up at a comedy show? Ironically, a comedian.
Who is the only actual brave comedian?
Who is someone that Americans hadn't heard of last week?
Who is someone that people from Brisbane couldn't pronounce until 30 minutes ago?
30 seconds ago.
That guy Googled it.
What is the question?
Oh shit, I didn't have the answer.
He only
had the answer.
See, now I was being pretty condescending about Brisbane before. But that's never happened. That has never happened. Being like, you say the answer, we guess the question. It's like, your guess is as good as mine, bro. Like, I don't know.
Do you even know who he is? He's like, it was just trending on Twitter. I don't know. I just read it.
I assumed it was like the new 5'8 for the Broncos. I don't know. Like fucking Vlad Zelensky. Like, yes. All right. So for future questions, that guy's blue shirt. We skip him.
Let's do Prepare to be Judged to close this thing out.
Yes.
So the way Prepare to be Judged works is we take a volunteer who will hopefully have no shame and be a gamer. We take a volunteer to be judged based solely on their physical appearance.
We don't know this person at all. We just size it. We just have a look at you, and that's what it is.
And we are going to guess, based solely on your appearance, we are going to guess where you're from, what you do for a living, and an interesting fact about you. What is your name?
Greg.
Greg.
You are from a newspaper office in the 1920s.
He didn't actually come out of a woman to be born. He actually crawled out of a hole on a golf course.
For a living. You go to bars and tell them they're mixing the drinks wrong.
In his spare time,
yeah,
he's a mime.
Those are not prescription. One giant round of applause for Greg, everybody.
Greg,
great sport, Greg. Thank you very much for participating. Ask Us Everything happens weekly, and you can watch from anywhere in the world. Get tickets and watch all 100 previous episodes at patreon.com/askuseverything.
Thanks for following and subscribing on YouTube, Facebook, TikTok, Instagram, and Twitter. If you don't yet, please do. If you want to see videos like this before anybody else, make sure to join my Patreon at patreon.com/Steve Hofstetter. There's a bunch of exclusive things there also. And make sure to see a live show. I've got a huge tour this year, including Canada, Australia, tons of places in America, and all over everywhere else. Well, not everywhere else. You can check for yourself at stevehofstetter.com. Thanks for watching.